Most of the residential buildings here have been destroyed. All that's left is the foundation and occasionally walls.
Добро пожаловать в Південне.
Russian-led militants razed this frontline village to the ground.
Сепаратисты называют этот поселок Ленинское.
The separatists call this village Leninske. Following the decommunization, it was renamed Pivdenne. Another name that is used by the separatists from time to time is Chigiri, and this is where the village begins.
The so-called separatists are in fact Russian occupiers. Back in 2014, they disguised themselves as local miners. Since then, they have been treating Ukraine like a testing ground.
Сюда приезжают курсанты артиллерии.
Artillery cadets come here, reconnaissance cadets, and they conduct their tests, their practical exams, shooting at us.
Before we arrived, Ukrainian soldiers had to fight yet another battle.
Они все ближе и ближе, все четче и четче начали попадать.
They are getting closer and closer, getting more accurate. We got sick and tired of this, and they gave us the go-ahead to respond to them a little. We employed heavy machine guns. Guys who are closer to them also used assault rifles. They didn't take that well, I guess, and today they greeted us with much heavier calibers.
By the heavier calibers, the soldiers mean barrel artillery. Fighting it here is pointless, since the militants hide their weapons in the residential areas of the city of Horlivka and fire from there.
The tactic is the same as it was in 2014-2015. They hide behind civilians, they hide behind buildings, so that later they can get good footage about evil Ukrainians shooting at civilians. We do not respond and do not aim at residential areas.
We have no choice but to take cover. Of course, if the situation is life-threatening, if they're getting close, then we respond with small arms.
Ukrainian troops don't respond to the provocations. They understand that the militants are simply trying to make them fire in response. However, when the shooting is targeted, they have to react.
Once we do respond, we don't fool around. We employ everything that we have available.
Shellings are regular here. We'd be glad to have put an end to this a long time ago, but our opponents do not want this to end.
For Ukrainian soldiers, peace means victory. They say that over the past 5 years of war, Ukraine has paid a very high price for independence.
What kind of peace would it be on their terms? It should be on our terms.
I don't know any Malorossiya, Novorossiya, or Sudorossiya. What are those? There is a country called Ukraine. My passport says I am Ukrainian. I was born in this country, and I'm fighting for my country. What they are fighting for, I have no idea.
Mikhailo knows this price too well. He comes from Donetsk, and his friends and relatives, just like those of many other soldiers, still live in the occupied city. Reported by Ihor Medelyan for UATV.